here in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go get riders! This is stage one of the Leadville Stage Race, brought to you by Stage Cycling 2022 edition. Have a great ride. We'll see you at Twin Lakes, athletes.
To my race. John here. Appreciate the click. Hope this race footage can help you in some way. Helps me a ton. I make these videos selfishly, obviously for me, mostly. Because I can go back through them, especially when they overlay with the speed power data, and I learn a lot about the race. It doesn't match my perception, so great way to do a post-race analysis and really figure out what you're doing out there, because a lot of times you'll find that what the data shows you is a little different than what you remember. But anyway, I put them up on YouTube because I figure that as I've been looking at some of these races, looking for recon footage and things, I haven't found a lot. Quality's pretty low, so I'm hoping that by putting these things up there, people will get a better sense of the course. Certainly not, that's not necessarily a Leadville thing, there's a lot of Leadville videos out there. But even still, I think the quality's not as high as it could be. But for other races, there's almost no footage. So I'm hoping that, again, if you're looking for a course recon, hopefully this helps you out. If you're looking for some distraction from the trainer for long winter rides, likewise, hopefully this helps out. And any critiques you have of my racing and racecraft, certainly throw them in the comments. Anyway, here we go. So, the Leadville Stage Race, the little brother or sister to the real LT100. But a great way to experience the course, get a sense of Leadville, get a sense of riding at 10, 11, 12,000 feet, and all the different pieces of the course, and see how you can put it all together for the big day. Super event, super course. Just can't say enough good things about it. So coming out of town, we start not at 6th and Harrison. We start down at the rodeo grounds. It's at the bottom of 6th Street, so pretty close to where you are. You should recognize things, and otherwise it stays true to the course for most of the way. I'll say that the top of Columbine, if I remember correctly, they didn't have us on the down switching over to that other fire road like they did in 2021, and I think they did it again in 2022 for the big day. So that was a difference, some pretty minor difference. And obviously the finish is not at 6th and Harrison as well. The finish is back at the rodeo grounds, so you don't have to go back up 6th Street. Otherwise, pretty much true to the course. So thank you. So one of the great things about the stage race is we don't start until 9 o'clock. So it's a little warmer. Let's see us cruising down the little road section. There's only about 250 riders. I think there were 240 some odd that started this year. About 211 I think finished. But at any rate, the temperature is a little bit better than 6:30 a.m. start for the big race. The weather for today, it was fairly cloudy. You'll see that, and I'll probably make some comments once we get up to say Hager and Pass Road. But you know, it looked pretty ominous for a good part of the day, and we did actually have a little bit of rain on us about 9 foot pipeline. Started to rain a bit, but it held off until I finished, and then it just downpoured. So the folks that were really slow behind me, it might have got wet. It was pretty nasty. But for the most part, it was great riding because not too hot. Just a great day out. So, as usual, everyone's cranking a lot. And I feel like I'm putting a decent effort in. Just kind of falling back. So it's a difficult thing to try and stay within yourself, quote unquote, when you can see, when you see people just pulling away from you. So. Now, probably not really standing in myself. I'm probably going a little bit too hard. But anyway, bike setup. I'm on a pivot Mach 4 SL. It's a 2021, I think. Since that's when I bought it. It's got the live valve setup. Live valve's not something I would recommend. I don't really feel like it does much for you, except add weight. And the tires, I ran 235 icons in the front, or not an icon, and recon race in the back, same 235. So probably a little bit earlier than I needed to. But it didn't roll quite as good as I could have. But I've had a couple of bad experiences with another brand's tires in a couple of other races this year, actually this year and last year, with some flats, and so I really didn't want to have any worry about flats, and there are some sections where, you know, if you can descend, you can pass some people and make up some time. Now for the most part, you don't really need a super girly tire, but which also I think you do need something that's on this course that, you know, can take some abuse on, say, Powerline down. Top of Columbine's can be a little bit rough, and depends on how you are on the bike. If you're light on your bike, then you have a lighter casing. But you don't need a lot. You really don't need a lot. So here we go. We're kind of, you know, making our way over to Kevin's for the opening salvo. Great way to break this up. So, you know, day one was out to Twin Lakes. So you get Kevin's, you get Sugarloaf line, you get Powerline down into Twin Lakes. Day two, which is really the easiest day, doesn't seem like it would be, but it is. You do Columbine, basically go up Columbine and back to Twin Lakes. And then day three is Twin Lakes in. I think day three is probably the hardest day, just because you have you've got 2 days of racing and your legs already, but you also have a line fly. So, hard to say. Day one and day three were both pretty comparable. But at any rate, as you can see here, again, you know, people passing me more than I'd like to see. So. right, so we made it to the first climb. So we're heading up Keevans. Here we go. Do a little butt check discussion. So I'm riding, as you can see by the head tube there, the top tube is a pivot. It's a pivot Mach 4 SL 2021, I think. This is the live valve edition with the XS1 axis componentry. For the chain ring, I'm actually running a 30, a Wolf 230. And I'm not sure if that was the right choice, but comments down below what you think. I've actually since then put the 32 back on for the barn burner race and Flagstaff, but also just for general riding. And tires, I went a little beefier than I probably needed to. I've had a couple of flats in a couple of different races late last year and early this year. So I'm a little bit gun shy on flatting, and I do like to go fast on the downhills, and I can pass a lot of people on the downs. So kind of want to be able to take those a little harder than you might normally. So I'm running a 235 Icon in the front and a 235 Recon Race in the back. And I liked those just riding around Northern Utah, coming up to things. Liked them during the race. Never had to worry about them. I could bash over anything. And I'm typically not a point and shoot bash kind of rider. I am kind of light on the bike and pick lines, but sometimes you can't pick a line, and sometimes you just need to bash over something. And I had zero issues with that during the week. That said, I probably won't run those next time I race, whether it's the big race or the stage race here at Leadville. I actually picked up a set of Conti Race Kings, which took like a pound off the bike, which was great. And I ran those at Barnburner, and they were awesome. So those might be my new favorites. I would like to see them in a 235 for the front, get a little bit more float. But they were fantastic. So anyway, what to say about Keevans? Keevans is a great climb. Pretty smooth, nice dirt road. It does get steep in a few spots, but it's entirely manageable. And it's a great intro. It's a great start to the day. It'll test you, but you should be fine. Kind of getting up through it and getting up over the top and through Carter Aid. That's a good milestone for the day.
Hey, how's it going?
You're a beast with no gears.
Yeah, nice job getting there where you got to. Oops, sorry. Coming to your left. Thank you.
So 45 minutes in, crested wins. But there's a little bit more climbing to go, so you've got this, there's a little bit of a downhill just prior to this, obviously, you just saw. But then you go into another bit of a little bit of a sloggy climb. So that takes you up to Carter Aid. So you look in the elevation profile there, that top piece is Carter Aid. And then once you get through Carter Aid, you're going to take a hard right onto the road, and that's that big downhill. You lose all that elevation you just fought for. That's Turquoise Lake Road, so you're going to take Turquoise Lake Road down for quite a bit. It's a good down. And then there's a little bit of a climb. And then we hit Hagerman's Pass Road, which is the dirt. So we'll see that in a little bit. But this section ran beautifully. Not much else to say, but generally stay on the gas a bit. There's one little kicker with some steepness that you'll see up here. But otherwise, it's relatively mild, kind of rolling a bit. So you can get some speed here, but we'll hit these ups. And I'm probably going a little harder than I thought I should. Hard to say. But trying to keep some momentum, get up these hills, not slow down to nothing, to fight over all these hills. So. At any rate,
Whew. Just a little top up with water.
So I considered cutting out this down. The video footage is not all that interesting. You didn't get to see a lot of my top two, a lot of my knees. But I thought it would be interesting, just from a course recon standpoint, so you can see the speed, see the turns, see the grade, the valid spots, and just generally see how long you're on this downhill. So. Forgive me for the uninspiring, perhaps, video portion, but I think there is some information to be gained from a course recon standpoint, so I left it in. I am going to speed up the turquoise lake road climb. If we get into climbs, that's just kind of boring. So I'll speed that up a little bit, and I'll actually speed up Hagerman's, because that's fairly straightforward as well. So you still get a sense of course, but you'll be just going a little faster than I was. As we make our way up Higgins Pass Road here, and we hit the hard left up the Sugarloaf climb. Sugarloaf climb, fun climb, fun descent. It's one that I feel like I was going reasonably hard. Could have gone harder, especially at the top. I've done this climb now 3 or 4 times. I know it reasonably, and but I was lagging a bit in this early section. I feel like I was putting out reasonable power within my constraints of FTP. So you know, this guy in front of me, I great thing about racing is you have those rabbits to chase. So it was my rabbit in this section here. So gave me just a little bit of motivation to pushing just a little bit harder. And this section, the grade's not tremendous. 5, 6, 7, 8% for the most part. And we'll see. I think that's about what it is, roughly. It's about a 25-minute climb for me. I'd like to get that down to 20, a little less, really. If you're Keegan Swenson, it's 10 minutes. But anyway, so great little fun.
Thank you. Feeling great. Yeah.
So here, definitely, I would have liked to have been pushing just a little bit harder, knowing that you're really close to the top, and you get a reprieve. It's some extended downhill afterwards. So I'm kind of soft pedaling just a little bit here. Trying to stay within myself and not burn myself out too badly. I'm still going to learn a lot of riding after this, but like I said, I do know that I'm close to the top, and it would have been nice to push just a touch harder and keep up with these people, or even get ahead of something, because as you'll see, I kind of got stuck behind a little bit of a train. Where I probably lost a few seconds, maybe more than a few seconds, going back down. So
thank you.
So here we are in the Powerline Descent, crested over the top of Powerline in Sugarloaf at 11,100 feet. Fun little descent, can be dangerous, because you can go really, really fast if you don't pay attention. Water bars and rain ruts, basically what you got to pay attention for. A couple rocky spots, but they're generally pretty good. Not a roadie. You can pretty much handle them at speed. I did really an awful job descending this year in the stage race. Some of it being behind people like here, trying to get around them, and maybe taking bad lines to get around them. But even later on, I was just taking bad lines for some reason, reading the trail wrong, playing following the leader a little bit.
On your right.
So keep that in mind. You can ride this better. You can go faster. Bottom section where it was really steep, I was fairly tentative. It's pretty off camber. When you get down there, you'll see. But at any rate, it's super fun. This really is a fun section to go through. We're gonna finally get past this person here. Yep, have to put a little dig in, but so you can make up some time going through this. Get some flow. A lot of people are kind of clenched up a little bit, but it's really not too bad. You land the bike, flow with the trail.
Thank you. on your right.
So as we get through that section, bump on the fence flyby, and I kind of wanted to go fast down this. We've ridden early in the week pretty quickly, and for some reason, well, and I know the reason, I was setting up for the hard right at the bottom. Dumb, because these rain ruts here were really deep. Again, the GoPro effect doesn't really do them justice. They were probably 8 to 10 inches deep, and I think I got into it. I think I leaned to try and get it back on track, and that's what took the tire out. So that was a fun crash. I really beat up my hip. I think I broke the tip of my finger on my left hand, on my middle finger, I think. Oh no, my ring finger. I had a good scrape in my elbow on the left side. And somehow scraped up my ankle as well. So, beat myself up pretty good for no good reason. But anyway.
Thank you. Thank you. How you doing?
Guys, as you can see, we're getting pretty angry at this point here. We're heading out to pipeline. I feel like I did fairly well in that road section, although there really weren't any people to work with. No one was really getting together and kind of doing any sort of drafting and working together. I was here trying to catch up to the the tandem, see if I can draft off them a little bit, but we're going to turn pretty quickly here. So I didn't really have a whole lot of advantage time for that. But it's going to start raining. I think you can see a little bit of raindrops in my garment there. So it starts raining here. And it started to rain somewhat steadily up into like line 8. This will take a turn off the road, get off onto the Jeep road here. So it's starting to rain a little bit. Still very comfortable up though. And it wasn't raining hard. Yeah, it was starting to rain somewhat steady, just not too hard. But I made the mistake, frankly, of throwing on my windbreaker rain jacket at Pipeline Aid, and I really probably shouldn't have. One, it ruins a lot of the footage, so it ended up going over the GoPro, so lost all that footage. No, so we have no footage of the single track. A lot of the gravel roads going into Twin Lakes, unfortunately. And it was a little warm, not too bad, but I really didn't need it. The rain stopped and pretty quickly, and it was unnecessary. But such is life. You gotta make those race decisions. And I didn't want to stop again. If it was going to keep raining, I didn't want to y'all get soaking wet either and be uncomfortable, because there's a good bit of riding after Pipeline. So that was the choice I made. It was the wrong choice in retrospect, but it's what it is.
on, John. Gotta be better than this. You got that. Gotta be better than this. Yeah. Yeah.
So rolling into Twin Lakes, you can see Twin Lakes up to the right there. This is a beautiful little downhill, and doesn't suck that bad as an uphill. You see, we're going pretty fast, get on the downs, but we'll come down and get across. I think it's 84 here. Which takes us over to Independence Pass, actually. We'll hop across the street and through the gravel road, over the dam, and that's it for the day. Hope you enjoyed the footage. Like I said, if you have any critiques, suggestions, drop in the comments. Love to hear them. Love to hear how they get faster. Where with high power, and where not to. Just general race craft. So thanks, and again, apologies for the bad footage with the windbreaker here. So anyway, till next time.
work.
Does the counting of when you come in when four in, they're like, somebody can help, the tents keep flying in. I was like, oh, I hope he doesn't come in while it's all down.
Well,